75 minuten. Waar pas je?
sábado.
Maewa.
take this experience with you as you enjoy Pandora!
Okay, everyone. Since Railroad doesn't want to help me out, it's up to all of you to help me get amped up. So when I say, if anyone...
Somebody with just a little... Oh, you're eating a biscuit.
Am I helping?
Yeah, you're Korean, of course.
Okay, let's get back on track. There we go. Hi, Jeremy.
Hi.
Say bye, Jeremy.
Bye, Jeremy. Pretty fast.
Bye. Jeremy did a good job.
Jeremy!
Any talking of meeting people, this is a show of hands. How many people have prepared to succeed? Five tests. How many tests?
Five.
You succeed. Yeah. On time, set them to the stopwatch. Anything you know, if you're missing your pocket, thank you. Get them out, set it to the timers.
Yes.
Because I'm going to say, on your mark, get set. You, the visitors, will all shout, set? Yeah.
There we go. Off the line at maximum speed. I don't know why I'm so surprised, but after all, if anyone can do this, Hot Rod can. Stop those clocks, everybody.
There goes my glowing reputation.
All right, let's see how I did. Hey there, travelers. What's my time?
13.53.
13.53. Okay, everyone, I really don't want to get eaten, so let's try this again.
Thank you. $5.32.
To stop when and if I can, but just for a couple of seconds at a time. I'd recommend putting any of those cameras onto sports or action setting just to make sure you capture some shots of actual animals instead of blurry. And if at any point today you have a question, do not hesitate to ask. My windows up here are always open for you. Right, on the right side of our truck, there is a gorgeous animal called an okapi. It's a chestnut brown colored body, black and white stripes on its legs. And a giraffe's out here. Towards a couple antelope on our right. Those are called greater kudu. Stunning rhino. That is a black rhino. Believe it or not, it's actually the smaller of the two rhino species we've seen on the reserve. Which is kind of crazy to me. That's the small one? They are still pretty big. They weigh between 2,000 and 3,000 pounds. They're a pretty shy species, so they need a lot more than we do. Animals on our left, these are called bongos, way at the top of the hill. Both the male and the female bongos have horns, which is a little bit unusual, but they're going to be using them to knock out low-hanging branches as they are running around in the forest. Please stay cool in the water. There's a bunch of hippos on our left. Look at all the hippos. Come out at nighttime to graze along the banks. And they can even sleep fully submerged, which is not an easy feat for something that breathes air. But they can hold their breath for about 8 minutes at a time, and they just kind of pop up to the surface to breathe without even waking up. It's awesome. It's like a reflex. But few birds in the river today as well. The big white ones are pink-backed pelicans. The smaller white ones are called great egrets. Looks like there's a great blue heron right at the edge of that island. Some black vultures as well. These quieter backwaters, pretty ideal places for these birds to spend their time. Lots of them eat fish, so there's ample amounts of food resources for them in the water. If I were a bird living in the river, I would want to be a little bit careful because there are some predators here. These are Nile crocodiles on our left.
That's a big croc, yeah.
They are huge. One of them is holding its mouth open, but don't worry, that's not because it's hungry. It's doing that because it got too hot. And because they're an ectothermic animal, they cannot sweat to cool down. So they just open their mouths. 11 pounds per square inch. All of that brute force. If they have eggs that are ready to hatch, they will roll them around in their mouths to break them open, making sure their babies are getting out safely. So a big group of giraffes like this is hilariously called a tower of giraffes. And in this particular tower, there have been 5 babies born in the last year and a half. I think we already see 4 of them. Check that out, that is awesome. Pruned back to giraffe height. You can always tell when they've been around. But they do quite a number on them. They eat 80% of their day faster, and that provides food for smaller hoofstock animals that will be migrating through. They all work together to shape this ecosystem. Those long legs. Since these animals are eating, their tongues are also prehensile, which means they can grab. And we're gonna go get a little closer view of those giraffes in a moment, but before we do, if you look on your left, there are a couple predators. Those are African wild dogs laying in the grass. They have black, tan, and white colored coats. They're commonly mistaken some Ankole cattle. Look at the size of the horns on this big brown one. They're just amazing. If we were to take a peek inside of those horns, we would see a structure that resembles honeycomb. So they're mostly hollow and surprisingly lightweight given their size. That is awesome. Ankole cattle are so cool. They're one of my favorite species on the reserve for sure. Now that I'll use them as a lookout point, we cannot all be as tall as a giraffe. A couple of lovely females on the left, another few babies. And then there's a really big guy over here on our left. That's Dad. So generally you can tell the difference between a mature male and female giraffe based on their ossicones because he uses them in a behavior called necking. Essentially males will smell that his tongue is really dark, it's almost a purple color. That's because giraffe tongues spend so much time out of their mouth every day that darker color prevents any sunburn. The colored ones at the top of the hill on our right, they're resting right now. And whenever they rest, they form these little clusters. They're facing in different directions to watch each other's backs. A little bit sneaky, we'll pull around. Ah, a little mandrel. It's more towards the front of the truck here, walking around. Really bright colors on their backside. Temperature by nearly 10 degrees, which really comes in handy on these hotter sedan on the left.
Sorry,
man. Now, since we figured this out, we've been using our resources from the Disney Conservation Fund to teach those farmers how to keep beehives that they put around their crop field. Keeps the elephants out in the first place.
Oh, they're fighting.
Now, this is very interesting what we're seeing on the left. We are seeing some sparring behavior. These are 2 younger males that are very similar in size and in age, so they're trying to figure out which one is more dominant. This is awesome. But usually those don't last very long, so this is a very cool thing to see. Flamingos enjoying the water today. When you think about a flamingo, usually you picture a bird that is a lot more pink than this. But there are 6 different types of flamingo. This one is the biggest. It also happens to be the palest pink. Oh wait, look back behind the flamingos. There's a big baobab tree. Then look to the right of that by that termite mound. There's actually a mom and baby elephant over there. And it looks like that little baby is nursing. So across the watering hole, way over to the right. Hearing because their eyesight isn't the best. See a black rhino in the forest? These are called southern white rhinos. They're a lot bigger, a lot more social, and they have a wider, boxier shape to them. So in this clearing, look at the 2 trees that are farthest right. It's walking right in between them. Yeah, compare the size of that cheetah to a rhino. Not gonna happen anytime soon. To be fair though, cheetahs are the smallest of the big cats. Big fluffy mane. Oh, look at cheetah. This is definitely a nocturnal predator. Nice. See a couple more rhinos and ostrich on the right, but they conserve their energy, lie and sleep 20 hours a day. Every day. Talk about a cat nap. Oh, this is so cool. Such a rare thing to see when it's light out.
It's a good one to be.
There's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. There are 6 eggs in that nest. That means 6 different ostrich have put them there. What else is going on before we start heading on back towards the village? Well, we have seen quite a few animals today. I do hope you guys see something more exciting or gorgeous. It's a lot lighter in color than most animals we've seen today because it spends a good amount of time in the desert. So a lighter coat will help keep it cool. Together we really can protect the wild places these animals call home. And also encourage you to get involved in conservation work around your own house. Spread awareness of the animals that you have seen today. The more we know about these animals, the more likely they are to stay protected. And above all else, I hope that you are taking the time to get outside and just enjoying the magic of nature. There is so much to discover out there, no matter where you're visiting us from. Looks, it has been a pleasure being your guide today. If you have any questions for me, feel free to come right on up to my window. But
really hard.
Expecting you.
Mr. Besides, this gentleman right here thinks I'm a gift, don't you, honey? Yes. What's your name?
Colin.
Colin? Well, I think that's Wahila, but it's my lucky day.
Everyone, Simba and the gang will be arriving any minute now.
Pause ready like this. Now let's hear it.
Let's make some noise. 1, 2, 3.
Oh,
It is then we are all connected in the great circle. A circle of life.
Thank you. Thank you. Thank you.
Look, it's Kevin.
Oh, that was a scary
scary tiger.
Oh, scary. How about something a little tamer than that?
A little tamer?
Yeah.
Okay. Kino, how about that little kitty cat?
Ah.
Aww. This is all beginning.
Yeah.
is filled with dino fossils. Above it, no dino.
That's proprietary. But the result is a breathtaking journey through a prehistoric world where you will witness the most spectacular creatures to ever walk the earth.
Commencing in T-minus 10 seconds and counting.
This is Seeker. Listen up. We've got to get in, grab Iguanodon, and get out before the asteroid hits. Let's roll. Now, let's go get that dino. Computer, what are you tracking?
Styracosaurus.
Not our dino.
Warning, meteor shower in range.
Just little one. Time to get serious. Launch autopilot on homing signal now. Identify!
Carnotaurus.
Definitely not our dino. Go, go, go! Another big guy coming up. Computer. Identify.
Sauropod.
Still not our dino, but at least this one's a vegetarian.
Thank you.
I loved it. That was a good one. He's better than even you. Those are so cute. Look at you. I know.
Thank you. Yeah, I will. Hi, Goofy. Hi guys! Why are you nuts? In the bushes! Ah, great!
Hi, what? Sorry. Who started this? You said look at all these chickens and now I'm just thinking of...
Risha Makadoo.
Where?
I don't know.
Hi there! Lefe. Nice to meet you!
Back in the saddle, you're in the front line, everyone's watching.
Yeah.
So
Listen for banshees. I don't hear any banshees.
Me either.
You hear any banshees down here? No? What about over here? Any banshees? This side, anybody hear a banshee? We better get